trying to promote the Green New Deal.
You come in here and you say it has to be my way or the highway. I don't respond to that. I know what I'm doing.
You know, this is one of those cases where you see a story or you see a video that comes out, your knee-jerk reaction is, these are cute kids. There must be something wrong that the senator is doing or saying, Senator Diane Feinstein. And that was a knee-jerk reaction. A lot of people who responded to her taking on these kids who were demanding that she essentially buy this new green legislation, hook, line, and sinker, the Green New Deal, said it was in the best interest of the country. They're kids. They're free to think that. Anyone is free to think and do that. She challenged him to say, you know, it's not all that good, and I have to find a way to see if we could pay for this. I'm cutting to the chase to cut to the reality here. Is she being overly vilified as a result of this? With me now, GOP strategist Noelle Nikpour, Run for America and CEO David Burstein, Fox News contributor Gianno Caldwell, and last but not least, my buddy Kat Timpf. Kat, what do you think of this? I think that she was unfairly maligned here.
I agree. I think that you would have to be a small child to think that the Green New Deal is any sort of good idea. Carbon emissions, obviously bad. Not a fan, but eliminating them completely in 10 years isn't just ridiculous, it's actually impossible. I mean, what would we have to do? Because I don't want to live like Laura Ingalls Wilder, Neil.
I
don't want to have to do my laundry in a basin. I like my washer and
dryer. Right now, send it out.
I like air travel. No, I do my own laundry, not to brag. I'm a woman of the people, Neil.
There you go. I understand.
So, and what was she supposed to do? I mean, what? Maybe the kids were kind of bullying her.
Well, you know, it's funny because, again, Gianno, I looked at this a number of times, and I mean, the reaction has been, you know, she's lecturing the kids, she's sounding all high and mighty, but what she's essentially saying is, you know, it's not your way or the highway. Now, that seems to be a little rich coming from anyone in Washington in this day and age where it does seem to be their way or the highway. But what she's saying is, I'm for a lot of these goals, but we do have to find a way to find middle ground so that we can get them through. But that was not really the take you got out of the media on it.
No, it wasn't, and I agree with her point on that. And I tell you, this Green New Deal, I don't see anything wrong with eliminating cow farts in 10 years. I mean, they're destroying the country right now.
It's impossible right now.
Exactly. But you know what is what's interesting? When we have a whole generation of young people that are listening to people like AOC, who seems to not understand tax policy, economics, or life in general, is no wonder why we're hearing this kind of rhetoric that's coming up. And I challenge every young person, especially those that are younger than me, to think critically for yourself, because you got to look at the facts on both sides and make a concrete decision. That's why free thinking and independent thinking is so important.
David, what do you think of that?
Well, look, I mean, the reality is we've got an environment right now where people are not having any kind of serious discussion about policy. I mean, these are huge, huge, complicated issues. And, you know, we do need to do something about climate change. But to suggest that because someone won't sign a bill that's only 11 pages long, that isn't even comprehensive, and then to criticize them for saying, you know, I'm not sure I'm going to do that, that seems a little bit ridiculous to me. You know, we may need a Green New Deal, but maybe this is not it. In terms of what's been proposed, and Diane Feinstein has been there a long time. I would like to see someone replace Diane Feinstein, to be sure, but she did get reelected. You know, people
by
had a chance
a million
to vote.
Votes,
you know,
right? Vote.
This
and
is
she
what
reminded the kids of that. You
right.
know? I don't know if I told you, but I'm in the United States.
She was dunking on the kids.
Absolutely, absolutely. What do you think, Noah?
I think that you know, first of all, the kids don't really. I feel that the kids don't really even understand the ins and outs of the Green New Deal and whether or not it's sustainable in the first place. So.
Let me understand here. You are taking Diane Feinstein's
side. Absolutely.
Could I do a Fox News alert with that?
Thank you, Neil.
All right. But your point is just what we're saying here, that it's one thing to recommend, it's another thing to kind of force it.
You know what? I'm not even so sure that, you know, that AOC and the some of the children probably on the same level with understanding some of the Green New Deal policy.
Right. Well, not even the people who signed on to it, because some have dialed it back, right? I mean, that's been a big problem, Kat. I mean, even Dick Durbin and others said, you know, we looked into this, a lot of it's not doable.
It's just not doable. It sounds nice. It would be great to have, you know, puppies and unicorns and everything work out wonderfully, but you just wanting something isn't enough to make it happen.
Even
and
Barney
people
Frank.
Like AOC don't understand
Barney
that.
Barney Frank even came on a business network and said that, you know, it was not sustainable.
It's not
you can't even shock a system like that. You can't just have all these out there.
But that doesn't take away that we need to do something about it. And I think the kids understand that because children are going to be living with the effects and consequences of climate change. That much we know is true for a long time.
By the way, they should be wide-eyed and look for that line about when you're young and liberal. You know, know, yeah. So I understand that. But, Gianno, I do think there was a certain pushiness to the kids, and that's fine. They're kids. Where it is our way, the highway. We think you should do this. And then what she is saying is there's a process here. That some I like, some I don't like, some features I think are favorable and doable, others are not. But the kids were hearing none of it. And I think in this day and age, they're a product of their parents and the environment in which we live, where a lot of people do think, we're only going to do this, we're not going to do that. And, you know, it takes some wheeling and dealing.
Yeah, and she came off like she was a teacher. And these were students, and a lot of them were students. Some of them look like they were 8 and 9 years old. So in that case, you have to teach them what's right and what's wrong. And you saw some adults.
Well, they
in the
were
room
8 and 9 years old. I mean, one of them was like my height.
No, quite tall.
16. One of them was 16.
Oh, yeah. 16.
So various ages. But again, this is why when it comes to elected officials, we need those that come into office that are experienced and actually know what they're doing, not just off some tweet and social media storm, and that's how they win. And AOC has been a great disappointment. You see what happened with the Amazon jobs, billions of dollars in lost tax revenue, because there's somebody who doesn't understand what she's talking about, and it had such a draconian effect.
All right. By the way, the aforementioned AOC, and I will never refer to her by those initials. I call her Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Congresswoman, and there's a reason for that. There is a reason for that, not to be haughty about it or to lecture kids, but she's in the news a lot for something else, over billboard. She's not happy. She wasn't using initials after this.